Somebody called me up the other day and they wanted my advice about where to live. They were thinking about selling their home and buying a bigger home in a different neighborhood. And then the next day, I was Skyping and learning with a couple and in another city, and they were also, they asked the exact same question. They said, where should we live? They're about to get married and they want to know where they should live. Now listen, as you know, I think everybody should live in Israel, but they were not ready for that move yet, but where they should live in their city. So the Torah speaks about this. The Torah speaks about how important it is to choose the right environment. Where you live has a big impact on you. And there are certain parameters. What's one of the parameters? One is that you need to pick a community where your wife will be happy. That it's very important that your wife is, now obviously we want the husband to be happy too, but if a happy wife is a happy life. So if your wife is unhappy, even if you like the neighborhood, but she's not happy in this neighborhood, you will not have a happy life. So, and for a woman, because it tends to be more of a relationship being, and so her neighbors mean a lot more to her. Her environment affects her much more than a man. So it's very important that the wife is happy. So that's what I told both of them. The first principle is, where is the woman going to be happy? So the second one was really based on where your children are at. Because if your children are little, you really have to be thinking about schools in the area and the children that they're going to be playing with in the neighborhood. And so that is definitely, obviously, a strong consideration. It turns out that both of these couples, their children are older. One, their kids are out the door, and one, their kids are just about to go off to college. So that really wasn't a factor. The third thing I said to them was, you should live in a neighborhood where you could comfortably walk to a synagogue that inspires you, that you love and that inspires you. And both of them are not religious. They're not Shomer Shabbat. But I said to them, but they're both growing. So I said, you have to think ahead. Maybe you won't be Shomer Shabbos. Maybe you'll still drive on Shabbat. But you need to purchase a home where you at least have the option that if you wanted to walk, you could. And it really, I saw them shift, and it really framed where they were at. I also told them, you should pick a neighborhood where there are people there who inspire you to grow, but there are also people in the community that you inspire. So there's a place where you don't feel you're at the lowest rung in terms of your spiritual growth, that there are people that you can also mentor, but that there are people, rabbis, rebbetzins, families that you can look up to. So these are the principles of the Torah that you should apply when making a very, very, very important decision where you should live. I'm Lori, Amos Live.